count inversions in an array. Inversions are pairs in an array which are not placed in sorted order. For a sorted array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the inversions count is 0 as there are no pair which are not in sorted order. Always the first element is less than the second element of the pair. If we move 5 to the left, that is for array 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. The inversion pairs are 5, 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 4. The inversion count is 4. For array sorted in reverse order, that is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All the pairs are inversion pairs. The inversion count in this case is 10. The brute force solution is to iterate over all the pairs using nested for loops and count the number of inversion pairs, that is when element at left is greater than the element at the right. Since we are using nested for loops, the time complexity is n square and the space complexity is O1 because we are not using any additional data structure in our algorithm. Now let's talk about the optimal solution. We can use divide and conquer method to arrive at the optimal solution. More specifically, we will use the classic merge sort. In merge sort, we divide the array in two halves, sort each half, finally merge the two sorted halves. Let's understand this with an example. Suppose our initial array is 4, 3, 2, 1. We divide the array in two halves, that is 4, 3 and 2, 1. We sort the first half, our array becomes 3, 4, 2, 1. We sort the second half, our array becomes 3, 4, 1, 2. Finally, we merge the two sorted halves, making our array 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you understand how the merge sort works. Let's understand how we can use it to count inversions. We will modify our merge sort function to return the inversion count as well. So our merge sort function does two things. It sorts the array and it counts the number of inversion pairs. Since merge sort is a recursive function, everything now boils down to the merge function. This is the classic merge function. It has two parts. The first part decides whether the element should be taken from the first half of the array or the second half of the array. Basically, it appends whichever element is minimum in the temp array. The second part of the algorithm appends rest of the elements of the two halves which were not covered in the first part of the algorithm. In the last step, we replace the elements of the input array by the elements of the temp array. I hope you get the basic idea of the merge function. Let's understand how should we modify our classic merge function to count the number of inversions. We make only three changes in the function. First, we initialize a count variable. Next, we increase the inversion count if the element in the right half of the array is smaller than that in the left half. Lastly, we return the count. The count is increased by the number of elements on the right side of the left element, including the left element. It sounds a little complicated, but it is fairly simple. Suppose our array is 2, 3, 5, 6, 2, 2, 4, 4. The first part of the array is between low and mid. The second part of the array is between mid plus 1 and high. Suppose the left index is pointing at 3 and the right index is pointing at 2. Since element at the left index is greater than that at the right index, it makes an inversion pair. That is 3, 2 is an inversion pair. Since the first part of the array is sorted, all the elements after the left index also match the inversion pairs with the element at the right index. There are 3 inversion pairs at this point. We increase the inversion count by 3. The number of elements between left and mid, including both left and mid, is mid minus left plus 1. And this is exactly the number by which we increase the inversions count. Let's take a look at the complete solution. Since we are dividing array in half at each step and go through all the elements of each half, the time complexity is n times log n. And since we are using temp array to store the sorted array in the merge function, the space complexity is n.